Hi, so Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Can you all hear me?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. Right. So just a couple of announcements. If you see on the LMS, we've been putting up an assignment, a homework, as well as a programming assignment, which are all, inshallah, due next week. You'll also have a small test this weekend, just based upon what we'll be covering this week. So just a small test. I think it should not take you longer than 15 minutes at max. So any questions from last time regarding TCP flow control we talked about, as well as in general, how does TCP work in terms of the acknowledgements as well as the initial sequence numbers and details regarding the reliable data transfer mechanisms that you have within TCP? Any questions related to that? Now, we said that TCP is a connection-oriented protocol. And the amazing thing is that you don't have a physical connection end-to-end. You just have state maintained at the end nodes. Now, in that state, what do you actually maintain? Well, you maintain before the users can exchange data between the sender and the receiver, you have a handshake. Now, a handshake simply means that whoever would like to set up the connection tells the other host that I would like to set up a connection. The host acknowledges by responding back that, okay, fine, go ahead and set up a connection. And if you think about this, this handshake could be a simple one, in which one host simply says, I would like to set up the connection, and the other one acknowledges back. That would be called a two-way handshake, a two-way handshake. And if you sort of think about this, what can happen is that in the two-way handshake, I'll just put in a new slide over here. So in the two-way handshake, so let's say that you have this equipment over here. Yeah. Right, so can you see this blank screen that I'm going to draw on? Can you all see this? Yeah, nay. Right? So can you see this? Up the screen, kaun si nazar aa rahi hai? Ji. Yeah, that's the one. Okay, so suppose I have here is my host A and I have host B. Now if I send a packet from host A to host B, send the packet here, okay? I would like to set up a connection, so that's the first one. And iske response mein, this one over here responds back and says, okay. So that would be a two-way handshake. So आपने एक पैकेट भेजा and उसके रिस्पॉन्स में आपको एक एक्नॉलेजमेंट आ गई. This would make up a two-way handshake. So this opens up a connection in one direction. Okay. So this is your timeline here. Let's get on that. Okay, there we are. Okay. Now the way this works is that I need to somehow specify to the other host that I would like to set up a connection. Now, वो करने के लिए basically what you do is you send a special control frame which has a bit set, which is the synchronization bits, the syn bit, ठीक है? So this control frame with this syn bit set tells the other host that this other host would like to set up a connection. And ye is response mein, it's going to come back with an acknowledgement for that. So that would open up a connection in one direction. Now, इसी तरह से अगर इस दूसरे ने एक कनेक्शन खोलना है तो इसने भी एक सिन भेजना है, ठीक है? And then of course this is going to respond back with an acknowledgement that okay, fine, I acknowledge that I am ready to receive data from you, and as soon as this acknowledgement gets back to this other host, okay, so that would confirm. So let's say this here is your host A, and this one over here is your host B. Okay, so host A sends a syn control message to host B. इससे host B को पता चलता है that A would like to open up a connection. It acknowledges back. Then sometime later, host B sends a syn message to host A, and this acknowledges back, and that opens a connection in the opposite direction. So you've got an exchange of four control messages. Now this second message you have acknowledgement भेज रहे हैं, if you collapse the second and third one into one message, if you collapse that into one message, then of course I can send back a syn as well as an ACK all in one message, okay? And I can achieve the same thing in a three-way handshake or an exchange of three control messages. So when I am responding back with the ACK, in the same control message, I also set the syn bit, and that tells host A that host B would also like to set up a connection in the reverse direction. So by exchanging these three control frames, okay, this is going to set up your connection for you. Okay? Now we may ask the question that why do we need three messages and will two not work? Okay? And to answer that, let's take a look at a few scenarios which tell us why there's a problem with looking at or exchanging just two messages. Okay? So any questions so far? Think about a two-way handshake. So इसमें एक यूजर दूसरे को कहता है लेट्स टॉक, एंड दैट इज सिंक्रोनस टू द सिन फ्रेम, एंड द अदर होस्ट रिस्पॉन्ड्स विद एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट व्हिच इज ओके. नाउ जब ये इस तरफ अगर लेट्स से लेट्स टॉक का इसको आप रिक्वेस्ट भेज रहे हैं एंड ये इसने यू ही इसको रिसीव किया है, लेट्स से दिस एस्टैब्लिशेस द कनेक्शन ओवर हियर, एंड ऑन रिसीविंग द ओके बैक, this one, the first one जिसने ये request भेजी है उसको confirmation मिल जाती है कि अच्छा दूसरा बंदा would also like to speak and the connection is established over here. So in a two-way handshake you would exchange just two messages, let's talk and okay, ठीक है? And let's talk मिलते ही connection establish हो जाता in the forward direction, and okay मिलते ही the connection is established for this user over here, okay, okay, the other user is willing to talk. Okay, now the problem over here is that let's say that you have these initial sequence numbers, so you'll choose an initial sequence number and you'll request a connection, and when you receive back an acknowledgement for that connection, okay, you know that the connection has established. So two-way handshake is going to be request for a connection, and ye jab acknowledge karta hai us connection ko, the connection is established. Now ideally what should happen is that sometime down the road, the client over here terminates. So, and if after a certain amount of time, there is no further activity from this particular user, so then the server should forget about this particular user. Now, what can happen is that let's say that you requested for a connection, and you then timed out. So user, the first user here, A, requests for a connection and times out. Now, because it times out, it then retransmits its request for a connection. And during that same time, suppose the other server, let's say we call this the host, we'll call this the client and this one the server. So the server, jo usne initial response bheji thi, wo aapke paas aa jati hai. So what has happened now is that the client has sent requests, a first one, jiski response raaste mein thi, time out kar gaye aap, and then you retransmit a request. Now when this original acknowledgement gets back to you, it confirms to the client that the connection has been established. Lekin ye jo aapne retransmission bheji hui thi, ye kahin baad mein pahunch rahi hai to the server. Now, suppose along the way, what happens is that the client terminates over here. And because it's been so long that this server has not heard from the client, the server forgets about this connection. And you have to do that, because if you don't hear from a client for a very long time, then you cannot just keep on maintaining state. Otherwise, your memory is going to grow without bound, and that will be a problem. So after some time, jab activity nahi ho rahi hai, the server forgets about this connection. And in the meantime, ye jo retransmitted request thi, ye packet pahunch ke aapke paas, and the connection is established as far as the server is concerned. सर्वर समझ रहा है कि कनेक्शन एस्टेब्लिश हो गया है, क्लाइंट मजे से टर्मिनेट करके बैठा हुआ है, तो सर्वर साइड पे यू हैव अ हाफ ओपन कनेक्शन, व्हिच मींस दैट देयर इज नो क्लाइंट एंड यू आर वेस्टिंग रिसोर्सेज ऑन द सर्वर साइड. ऑफ कोर्स इस एस्टेब्लिशमेंट के बाद होगा ये कि आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम विद नो एक्टिविटी, दिस विल टाइम आउट, बट इट दीज सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग्स कैन अक्रू एंड can result in a failed situation, a failure situation, and we'll talk about that in a minute. So this is an example of a half open connection where the server has an established connection, whereas the client has happily terminated. Now, this can happen in a number of other scenarios. Usually the way it works is that you choose a certain initial sequence number and acknowledgement of wapas bhejte hain, and that sort of establishes the connection. Then once the connection is established, you start sending data with the next sequence number, and that is accepted by the client. At some point when you have no further data to send, the client will terminate, and if the server gets no activity from that particular client, it's going to forget about that particular client. But here we saw that before this got there, you retransmitted, and that results in the half open connection. Now a three-way handshake prevents this from happening, and basically if you have a client which is not exactly in the listen state, there's a typo over here. This should be that your client should begin from a closed state. And we'll update that as well. So notice that if you want to sort of understand the finite state machine for this, aapke paas दोनों क्लाइंट एंड सर्वर इनिशियली क्लोज स्टेट में है. जब क्लाइंट एक रिक्वेस्ट भेजता है कि आई वुड लाइक टू बिगिन अ कनेक्शन, इट सेंड्स अ सिन फ्रेम और अ सिन सेगमेंट, आई शुड से नॉट अ फ्रेम, अ सिन सेगमेंट, बिकॉज सेगमेंट इज अ वर्ड दैट यू यूज फॉर द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर प्रोटोकॉल डेटा यूनिट्स. and goes to a state called the SynSend state. Now the server, when it opens up a connection, it's in what you call a listen state. So a server is always going to be in a listen state when it is ready to receive connections from clients. Jab ye socket khol leta hai, it is in a listen state, and it is typically listening to clients on a well advertised port, because the client should know ki mujhe agar server se connect karna hai to kis port number pe connect karna hai. So that's a predetermined, well advertised port that the server is listening on. The client is going to send a SYN request on that particular port. When the server receives a SYN request, then of course that will result in the server having received that SYN, and it establishes the connection. Okay? And it's going to send back an acknowledgement. When the client receives this acknowledgement, okay, the connection is established in that direction. Also, what happens is that the server sends a SYN frame in the opposite direction along with the acknowledgement. So it sends a SYN ACK, okay, and that on receiving that SYN ACK, because ye is a SYN from the server, okay, the client is going to then send back an ACK. And that is going to complete the connection for the client in the opposite direction. Now we'll take a look at how this looks. So the client is in the close state, and the server is in the listen state, ready to take on a SYN frame from a SYN segment from a client. So you means aapke paas ek SYN सेगमेंट रिसीव होता है, ठीक है, यू गोइंग टू रिस्पॉन्ड बैक विद अ SYN ACK. An ACK in response to this SYN, and another SYN जो के is opening up a connection in the opposite direction. On receiving this, the client sends back an ACK. ठीक है, so ये मिलने पे, ये ACK मिलने पे client का connection establish हो गया, और सर्वर को एक मिलने पे सर्वर का ये कनेक्शन यहां पे एस्टैब्लिश हो गया. सो द स्टेट्स आर क्लोज्ड एंड लिसन. वंस यू सेंड द SYN, द क्लाइंट मूव्स टू द SYN सेंड स्टेट. ऑन रिसीविंग द SYN, द सर्वर इज इन द SYN रिसीव्ड स्टेट एंड रिस्पॉन्ड्स विद अ SYN एंड एन ACK. द ACK इज रिस्पॉन्डिंग टू द SYN, and this SYN is opening up a connection in the opposite direction from the server to the client. On receiving this SYN ACK, essentially on receiving this ACK part, the connection is established for the client, and on receiving the ACK back from the client, the server's connection is established. Okay, now so if you recall in the TCP header, ठीक है, आपके पास यू हैड दीज स्पेशल बिट्स ओवर हियर. यू हैड अ SYN बिट, ठीक है, यू हैड एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट बिट. तो ये बिट्स यहाँ पे, ये छह स्पेशल बिट्स हैं. इनमें से ये बिट्स नॉर्मली विल बी जीरोस, बट व्हेन इन दी स्पेशल कंट्रोल सेगमेंट्स, उनके लिए ये SYN बिट सेट होगा. सो व्हेन यू रिसीव a control frame with this SYN bit set, that corresponds to the SYN segment in response. So that's a segment which contains no data. So just contains a TCP segment header with the SYN bit set. That's a SYN segment. A TCP header which has the SYN and the ACK is a SYN ACK. And uske response pe, then you're going to send back a segment with the ACK. Because over here, once you receive the ACK back, okay, the connection is established. Okay, just put this down like this one here. Let's just go through this again. Where did it go? Yeah. Delete ho gaya. So on receiving the ACK back, the connection is established. ठीक है, यहाँ पे ये connection establish हो गया. So ये जो frame जा रही है, it's acknowledging the SYN sent over here. But because यहाँ पे connection establish हो गया है, therefore if the client has data to send, इस frame में you can send data to the server. Okay. And when that frame is received by the server, it contains the ACK that will establish the connection, and uske sath data bhi aapko mil jata hai. So that saves on exchanging frames. So initially, ye jo do pehli control frames hai, unme data nahi hota. You just have a control frame which has no data at all, just the SYN bit sent. And in the second one that is coming from the server to the client, you have a SYN and ACK bit set. On receiving the ACK, the connection is established. So now the client can send data to the server. Usi ke andar ACK bit bhi set hai, theek hai? And that tells the server that, okay, jo aapne SYN bheja tha, uske response pe ACK bit is set. So it knows that, okay, on receiving that, the connection is established in the reverse direction, but forward direction ke andar, it can receive that data. Okay. Right, so any questions on this three-way handshake? So it's a very simple mechanism. Client says, I would like to open a connection. Server says, okay. And now I would also like to open a connection in the reverse direction. The client then responds by saying, okay. So by the exchange of these three control messages, third one can also contain data. You have maintained all the information necessary for the connection, okay? And usme you have a sequence number which is used for all the data being sent from the client to the server. You have another sequence number which is used by the server to send data to the client. So isko pehle wale ko sequence number X keh rahe hain, dusre number ko sequence number Y keh rahe hain. On receiving the SYN bit set and the sequence number X, the server is going to respond with an acknowledgement with X plus one. So although you don't have data sent, the acknowledgement is still X plus one. Along with the SYN bit set, the sequence number Y for connection from the server to the client. On receiving the ACK X plus one, the connection is established. And on receiving this SYN bit, set with the sequence number Y, this acknowledges that I am willing to accept this and acknowledges with a acknowledgement number of Y plus one and the ACK bit set. Okay. So beech mein notice we're just showing one sort of exchange, but this could be across multiple hops that you actually get to the other side. Okay. And here in summary, you're enclosed. It, you open a socket, you create a socket, and you start accepting connections. You're listening. The server is in the listen state. The client sends the SYN and moves to the SYN send state. Okay. On receiving the ACK back, the SYN ACK from the server, it moves to the established state. On being in the listen state, on receiving the SYN from the client, it moves to the SYN received state. Uske baad, it's going to send its SYN ACK, and on receiving the ACK back for the sequence number that the server is using, which is Y, on receiving an ACK of Y plus one, the server also moves to the established state. And then you start having an exchange of data between the client and the server. Now, इसी तरह से जिस तरह से you're exchanging messages to indicate to the other party that you want to set up a connection, in the very same manner you exchange messages between the client and the server to tell the other party that you would like to terminate a connection. So चूंकि दो connections खुले हुए हैं, one from the client to the server और एक from the server to the client, you have to close the connection in both directions. And how do you close the connection? Once again, you use a special bit in the TCP header, which is the fin bit. Us bit ko jab aap set karke bhejte hain, so that's an indication to the other side that the other side would wish to close down the connection. So on receiving the fin bit set in a TCP segment header, theek hai, hoga ye ke the other side knows ke dusri side jo hai would like to close down the connection, and usko aap acknowledge karenge, theek hai. And this can take place simultaneously. Yeah, ek side ka connection band hoke reh sakta hai, and then subsequently data can be still coming from the other side. Jab dusri side bhi band karna chahta hai, it's going to send a fin in the opposite direction, and then both of them are going to close down their connections. ठीक है? So suppose client है, established state में है, server is also in the established state, and this sends a fin bit. ठीक है? Telling the server के the client would has no further data to send, and it would like to close the connection from the client to the server. ठीक है? So, server को जब ये fin bit receive हो गया, तो server knows कि अच्छा जी ये client मज़ीद data नहीं भेजेगा. So it moves from the established to the close wait state. It can still send data from the server to the client, so it can still keep on sending data. On receiving this ACK back, ठीक है, it moves to the fin wait 2 state. So on sending the fin, it's the fin wait 1 state. It can no longer send data, but can still receive data. And on getting the ACK back, it moves to the fin wait 2 state. Okay. Now, जब सर्वर कनेक्शन को क्लोज डाउन करना चाहता है, it has no further data to send. It's going to send this fin bit 1 to the client. ठीक है? And on receiving this fin bit 1, the client is going to move from the fin wait state to the timed wait state. ठीक है? And send back an acknowledgement. Now, why does it go to a timed wait state and simply not close down the connection? उसकी वजह ये है कि हो सकता है कि जो आपने ACK भेजा है, this gets lost on the way. So the server has sent a fin bit, उसको ACK अगर नहीं मिलता है, तो वो अभी, although it has no further data to send, उसको ये confirmation नहीं मिलेगी. ठीक है? And because of that, ठीक है, what you're doing is you're not in immediately closing down the connection. You might have other data जो कि hop by hop आ रहा है and in pipeline में है, it has still not arrived. So you still wait. ठीक है? And you wait for at least 2 times that a segment stays alive within the network. Typically values 30 seconds, 1 minute, or 2 minutes rakhi jati hai by default. And you're going to close after that. Okay. And isi tarah se, when this has sent in the last fin bit, on receiving the ACK from here, it moves to the closed state. Okay. Right, so any questions over here in closing down a TCP connection? Ji, any questions here? Yeah, there's some questions here. The segments. So we use the word segment for the transport layer PDU. We use the word packet for the network layer PDU in general, and we use the word frames for the data link layer PDUs. UDP ke liye, some books also use the word some books also use the word datagram, but usually the word segment is used for the transport layer. TCP ke liye often we exclusively use the word segment. Okay, so the hand up here, Hafiz Saab, any questions? Ji, Aves ji,
assalam alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Sir, ye timer wala zara dobara batayega, ye TCP connection mein टाइमर सर, टाइमर एंड टाइम शेड में अब जाता है सर, एंटर दोबारा वेट करता है.
ओके, सो ये इसलिए करता है कि देखिए ये जो ACK है, दिस कुड गेट लॉस्ट ऑन द वे. दिस ACK ओवर हियर दैट यू हैव ट्रांसमिटेड कुड गेट लॉस्ट ऑन द वे. ठीक है, एंड सो व्हाट कैन हैपन इज दैट ऑल्दो द सर्वर हैज has sent the fin bit that it has no further data to send, ठीक है, जब तक सर्वर को ACK वापस नहीं मिलेगा, ठीक है, what can happen is that it will not move from the last ACK stage to the close stage, ठीक है, so ACK अगर गुम जाता है यहाँ पे, so then this server will retransmit that ACK, ठीक है, and अगर आपका यहाँ पे connection foreign से close होगा, तो जब वो ACK आपके पास आएगा and you close the connection, so you will get into a problem because आपने इस particular जो sim ये जो sequence numbers है उसके corresponding या इस connection के corresponding आपने उसको close कर दिया है और आपको एक ACK मिला है which you're not going to respond back with an ACK to that. So you receive a fin bit दोबारा and आप उसको दोबारा ACK नहीं करेंगे because that will not belong to a connection जो कि open है over here. ठीक है? So notice आपने इस direction में तो connection close कर दी. You have no further data to send. ठीक है? Server might still have data to send and it's sending data to you. When the server has no longer data to send, it sends a fin bit to you, जिसको आपने acknowledge करना है. And acknowledgement मिलने पे server ने connection close down करना है. अब सर्वर को एक्नॉलेजमेंट नहीं मिलती बिकॉज आपने जो एक भेजा था वो घूम गया रास्ते में या इट गॉट लॉस्ट ऑन द वे सो द सर्वर इज गोइंग टू देन रीट्रांसमिट दिस एक अगेन टू यू इट्स गोइंग टू सेंड दिस फिन बिट अगेन टू यू नॉट एन एक इट्स गोइंग टू सेंड द फिन बिट अगेन टू यू सो इफ योर कनेक्शन इज ओपन यू आर गोइंग टू रीट्रांसमिट दैट एक अगेन बट इफ योर कनेक्शन इज क्लोज्ड ओवर हियर सो देन ऑफ कोर्स वो आएगा आप उसके ऊपर कुछ नहीं करेंगे बिकॉज इट डजेंट बिलोंग टू एन ओपन कनेक्शन ठीक है तो ये टाइम आउट करेगा फिर फिन भेजेगा आप फिर कुछ नहीं करेंगे फिर टाइम आउट करेगा फिर फिन भेजेगा तो ये फंस जाएगा ठीक है इट विल गो इनटू अ इनकॉन्ग्रुअस स्टेट दैट्स व्हाई यू इवन दो यू रिसीव द लास्ट फिन बिट एंड आप फॉरन से ACK भेज देते हैं आप स्टिल कनेक्शन को फॉर सम टाइम 30 सेकंड्स 1 मिनट और मे बी 2 मिनट्स Typically, two times the maximum segment lifetime corresponds to your round trip times. कि जितनी देर के लिए network में ऐसे segment stays alive, roughly 30 seconds to 2 minutes के time के लिए आप इस connection को मज़ीद खोले रखते हैं और उसके बाद खुद से उसको close कर देते हैं on the assumption कि अब ACK should have got there and if the ACK didn't get there, you would have by this time got a retransmitted fin bit again. Okay, so that simply ensures that if there was some data which was out of sequence and that was supposed to be received, wo bhi pahunch jaye, as well as if your ACK has been sent, that if that got lost on the way, then you would have received a time after time out another fin bit, jiske upar aap dobara se ACK bhejenge, wo process bhi ho jaye. That's why you wait approximately 2 times your maximum segment lifetime. Before you close, okay?
Yes, sir. This happened.
Okay. So, any further questions on closing down a TCP connection? Okay. Wonderful. So, the next thing that we're going to talk about is congestion control, and congestion control informally means that when you have too many sources sending too much data too fast in a net for the network to handle, then you have a problem in the network. How does that take place? Well, जो आपके पास buffers हैं in the intermediate routers, वहाँ पे packets are going to get lost because of overflow. Also, if you've got these long queues in these intermediate buffers. That will result in long delays. Okay, so congestion is one of the top 10 networking problems that you have in terms of research. That how does one alleviate congestion? Congestion, agar ho jaye, to usko kaise kam karte hain? Basically, you would want to throttle back on the data that you are pumping into the network. You want to slow down, taake congestion jo hai. वो कम हो जाए ठीक है Otherwise, if you keep on pumping further packets into the network, that's going to result just like fuel on fire, and things are going to slow down even further, and no packets are going to get to their destinations, and you will have more and more congestion. Yes, ye jaise road networks hai, aapke paas ek road network mein jitni gaadiyan, let's say network ke andar aa jaate hain, if you have congestion, then you have a traffic jam. If you have a traffic jam, then the good thing in computer networks is that after some time, when those buffers overflow, then those packets are lost along the way. And if they are lost, then of course they have to get retransmitted if they belong to a connection which is a reliable connection. Whereas if they belong to a connection which is unreliable, of course they're lost, and then the application has to recover from that situation somehow. ठीक है, लेकिन अगर रिलायबल कनेक्शन को बिलोंग करते हैं, लेट्स से आप फाइल ट्रांसफर करते हैं, बीच में कोई पैकेट्स गुम हो गए हैं, यू गोइंग टू रीट्रांसमिट देम. सो व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू रीट्रांसमिट देम, दे ऐसा नहीं होगा कि वो खत्म होंगे फ्रॉम द नेटवर्क, दे हैव टू बी रीट्रांसमिटेड. ठीक है, सो इफ द नेटवर्क इज कंजेस्टेड, देन यू हैव अ प्रॉब्लम, बिकॉज इफ यू कीप ऑन पंपिंग मोर एंड मोर पैकेट्स विदाउट द नेटवर्क बिकमिंग इनटू अ स्टेट व्हिच इज कंजेशन फ्री, यू आर इन ट्रबल. ठीक है, so you can think of this like this. First scenario mein hum ye consider karte hain ki I have an infinite buffer over here, an unlimited resources hai mere paas. I have an infinite queue over here. Jitne packets aap dalenge, no packet will get lost. Notice that packets will get lost if the buffer overflows. So if you have a finite buffer, let's say a queue hai, usme aap 10 ki capacity hai aapke paas. 11वां पैकेट अगर आएगा तो वो जाहिर है ऑलरेडी क्यू फुल है, 10 की स्पेस है वहां पे, 10 के 10 वहां पे ऑलरेडी पैकेट्स आपसे पहले लाइंड अप है, तो 11वां विल गेट लॉस्ट बिकॉज इट कैन नॉट बी क्यूड. लेकिन अगर आपके पास इन्फिनिट बफर स्पेस है तो 11वां क्यू होगा, 12वां क्यू होगा, 1000वां क्यू होगा. ठीक है, जितने पैकेट्स आते जाएंगे वो क्यू होते जाएंगे, होते ही जाएंगे क्यू. ठीक है, एंड जब तक के वो आगे से पैकेट्स नहीं खत्म होंगे, प्रोसेस नहीं होंगे, आपके पास द क्यू इज गोइंग टू ग्रो विदाउट बाउंड. ठीक है, सो दैट विल रिजल्ट इन एज द इनपुट रेट इंक्रीसेस. ठीक है, आपके पास क्यूइंग सिस्टम में या नेटवर्क के अंदर डिलेज जो है, दे आर गोइंग टू ग्रो एंड ग्रो एंड ग्रो विदाउट बाउंड. ठीक है, एज यू अप्रोच अ रेट व्हिच कॉरेस्पॉन्ड्स टू द मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल रेट, then of course your delay is going to grow to almost without bound. theek hai, so kisi bhi queuing system mein stability ke liye zaruri hai ki jo average arrival rate hai aapka wo average service rate se kam ho. agar average arrival rate average service rate se zyada hai to aapki queue is going to grow without bound, and kyunki aapke paas infinite waiting space hai, it's just going to keep growing and growing and growing and growing, which will result in a longer and longer delay for the packets to be processed. Okay, is this clear, Ji? Any questions here, Ji? Suppose you have two hosts, host A and host B, theek hai, and you have a certain capacity which is capital R. Now ideally you're going to share that equally between host A and host B, which means that आपके पास द मैक्सिमम पर कनेक्शन थ्रूपुट दैट यू गोइंग टू गेट फॉर ईच ऑफ दीज कनेक्शंस इज आर बाय 2. ठीक है, सो थिंक ऑफ दिस दैट आपके पास ओरिजिनल डेटा इज कमिंग इन फ्रॉम द सोर्स एट अ रेट व्हिच इज लैम्डा इन, एंड इट्स अराइविंग एट द एप्रोप्रिएट डेस्टिनेशन एट अ थ्रूपुट व्हिच इज लैम्डा आउट. ठीक है, नाउ ऑफ कोर्स व्हेन यू इंक्रीज लैम्डा इन, ठीक है, यू कैन गेट ऑल द वे टू R2, एंड प्रोपोर्शनली आपका थ्रूपुट भी उसी तरह से बढ़ता जा रहा है, बट इट्स गोइंग टू बी कैप्ड एट R/2, बिकॉज़ बियॉन्ड R/2, इवन इफ यू इंक्रीज द इनपुट रेट, द थ्रूपुट कैन नॉट गो अबव दैट, एंड इफ द इनपुट रेट गोज अबव R/2, देन व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इज दैट क्लोज टू R/2 आपके पास डिलेज जो है ना वो asymptotically badhti jayengi, they're just going to go on increasing and increasing. Okay, so typically you have a knee point over here as you increase the rate. Jaise इफ यू नोटिस के आपके पास लेट्स से किसी भी ट्रैफिक नेटवर्क के अंदर इज अ सर्टेन कैपेसिटी दैट दैट लेट्स से एक ट्रैफिक लाइट है आपके पास और गाड़ियां आ रही हैं ट्रैफिक लाइट पे क्यू करती हैं एंड यू नोटिस दैट इधर वो कंजेशन में होता ये है कि जो ही कंजेशन बढ़ती है एक सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ कंजेशन के बाद एकदम से लंबी लंबी लाइनें लगना शुरू हो जाती है इज अ नी पॉइंट बियॉन्ड व्हिच सडनली यू हैव अ वेरी लॉन्ग वेटिंग टाइम थोड़ा सा लोड इंक्रीज करने से बहुत ज्यादा फर्क पड़ता है इन योर डिले इन योर वेटिंग टाइम एंड दैट्स टिपिकल ऑफ ऑल क्यूज दैट व्हेन द इनपुट लोड इज बिलो अ सर्टेन थ्रेशोल्ड ठीक है your delays are small but suddenly when the input increases above a certain threshold above a knee point your delays become very very large theek hai so delay aapka linear nahi hai delay aapka non linear hai it's you have a knee point beyond which increasing the load slightly will result in a very large delay for packets in an infinite queue ठीक है एंड यू कैन थिंक ऑफ दिस के ट्रैफिक नेटवर्क्स के अंदर भी बिकॉज ऐसा नहीं है कि गाड़ियां ड्रॉप हो रही हैं गाड़ियां क्यू करती जाती हैं ठीक है सो दैट्स वेरी एनालॉगस टू एन इनफिनिट क्यू व्हेन कार्स कम एंड सॉर्ट ऑफ क्यू अप एट अ ट्रैफिक सिग्नल यू सी दिस बिहेवियर ऑल द टाइम दैट व्हेन द अराइवल रेट इंक्रीजेस अबव द रेट जिसके ऊपर गाड़ियां जो है ग्रीन लाइट के ऊपर प्रोसेस की जा सकती हैं तो लेट्स से बिटवीन अ साइकिल द लाइट्स गोइंग फ्रॉम ग्रीन बैक टू ग्रीन अगेन 10 कार्स कैन पास थ्रू ए ट्रैफिक लाइट और उसी साइकिल टाइम के अंदर 12 या 14 15 गाड़ियां आ रही हैं तो हर साइकिल पे 5 गाड़ियों की क्यू जो है ना वो बढ़ती जाएगी एंड वेरी क्विकली यू विल सी दैट द डिलेज आर गोइंग टू राइज वेरी वेरी लार्ज Okay, so you'll have this kind of a behavior. Any questions here, dear? Now,
sir.
Ji.
Sir, what is this maximum upper connection throughput graph showing? Can you please explain again?
Okay, so what we're showing over here is that suppose you had. Hosts, host A and host B, which are sharing a link which has a capacity of R. Okay? So the maximum throughput per connection is going to be R by 2, ideally. Okay? Agar equally share kar rahe hain is capacity ko, to ye host A can put in R by 2, host B can put in R by 2. Okay? So if I were to look at the output throughput, okay? The throughput. For one of these connections, it's going to be capped at R by 2. Okay? So if the input arrival rate of the original data is R by 2, the output at max can be R by 2. If the arrival rate increases above R by 2, to mujhe throughput R by 2 hi milega. So this therefore, this lambda out is point ke baad, you can't get more than R by 2 as the output. The input is going up. Okay? इस ग्राफ में द इनपुट इज गोइंग अबव आर बाय टू द आउटपुट इज स्टिल आर बाय टू बट नोटिस दैट क्लोज टू आर बाय टू द डिले इज गोइंग टू ग्रो विदाउट बाउंड ठीक है सो फॉर एनी इनपुट अराइवल रेट अबव आर बाय टू आपके पास बहुत लंबी डिलेज होंगी बिकॉज वट इज हैपनिंग इज दैट दिस इंफिनिट बफर इज गोइंग टू कीप ऑन फिलिंग अप एंड द नंबर ऑफ packets that you're going to have queued up over here will grow larger and larger and larger utni aap processing kar nahi sakte jitne piche se packets aa rahe hain to ye queue without bound grow ho rahi hai therefore delays aapki bahut lambi ho rahi hain jis rate pe output ja sakta hai yahan se bahar wo capped hai to capacity r and agar ye dono jo connections hai ye equally share karte hain apne rates ko to aapke paas r by 2 hi aata jayega Okay, is this clear? The graph clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now suppose that आपने क्या किया कि आपने यहाँ पे इस क्यू को इनफिनिट की बजाय फाइनाइट कर दिया. So you have now a certain fixed capacity over here for the queue size. अब होगा ये कि अगर पैकेट अराइव करता है और क्यू फुल है तो पैकेट विल गेट ड्रॉप्ड. बिकॉज दैट पैकेट गेट्स ड्रॉप्ड, ठीक है, तो टीसीपी के लिए दैट पैकेट विल हैव टू बी रिट्रांसमिटेड, ठीक है, दैट पैकेट विल हैव टू बी रिट्रांसमिटेड. आपके पास एक राउटर है विद अ फाइनाइट बफर और इट्स बीइंग शेयर्ड बाय दीज टू कनेक्शंस, ठीक है. नाउ द सेंडर रिट्रांसमिट्स पैकेट्स व्हिच हैव टाइम्ड आउट. सो देयरफॉर एप्लीकेशन लेयर से जो ऊपर इनपुट आ रही है वो तो लैम्डा इन आ रही है, ठीक है, लेकिन ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर से जो चीज आपके पास नेटवर्क के ऊपर कैरी हो रही है that is a combination of the original data rate plus the retransmitted data. So lambda in dash is going to be greater than lambda in. ठीक है, मेरे पास एक फाइल है भेजने के लिए ऊपर से आ गई फ्रॉम द एप्लीकेशन लेयर, मैं उसको मैसेजेस में ब्रेकअप करके सेगमेंट से ब्रेकअप करके भेज रहा हूं, उनमें से कोई ना कोई सेगमेंट जो है वो रास्ते में बफर ओवरफ्लो की वजह से लूज हो जाता है, मुझे वो सेगमेंट दोबारा भेजना पड़ रहा है. तो इफेक्टिवली जिस रेट्स पे मैं यानी इफ आई लुक एट द अमाउंट ऑफ ट्रैफिक बीइंग पुट आउट ऑफ द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर दैट इज गोइंग टू बी ग्रेटर देन द अमाउंट ऑफ ट्रैफिक रिसीव्ड बाय द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर फ्रॉम द एप्लीकेशन लेयर, बिकॉज ओरिजिनल डेटा के साथ मुझे रिट्रांसमिटेड डेटा भी ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर एंड फिर कंसिक्वेंटली नेटवर्क लेयर लिंक लेयर के ऊपर भेजना है. इज दैट क्लियर कि ये लैम्डा इन प्राइम लैम्डा इन से क्यों बड़ा? एनी क्वेश्चंस हियर जी? नाउ ऑब्वियसली लैम्डा आउट जो आपके पास है, ठीक है, वो तो आइडियली लैम्डा इन के बराबर ही हो सकता है एट बेस्ट, ठीक है, बट इन दिस सिनेरियो नाउ व्हाट यू हैव इज दैट यू हैव एन ओरिजिनल रेट, you have a lambda in prime which is the original data rate plus retransmitted data, okay, and you have a lambda out which is the rate at which packets are or segments are arriving at the other side, okay. So original packet aaya, iski copy aapne rakh di, copy, and you had free space and this is going to go through fine. वहां से एक्ट जब वापस आएगी तो आपके पास ये जो कॉपी है इसको फिर रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, वरना सो व्हाट यू नोटिस ओवर हियर इज दैट इफ यू हैव द ओरिजिनल रेट डेटा इन लैम्डा इन एट बेस्ट आपके पास अगर कोई ना कोई पैकेट्स नहीं गिर रहे, नथिंग इज गोइंग रॉन्ग एट बेस्ट, इफ थिंग्स आर गोइंग परफेक्टली फाइन, लैम्डा इन को जो आप बढ़ाते जाएंगे लैम्डा आउट भी उसी तरह से लीनियरली बढ़ता जाएगा until you get to the capacity limit jo ke is connection ke liye r by 2 hai. Notice total capacity r hai, do connections share kar rahe hain, hum assume kar rahe hain ke at best both are equally sharing it, so r by 2 is the limit, theek hai. Now agar buffer full hai raste mein and ye gaya buffer, pehle to free space tha lekin ab buffer full hai, to kya hoga ke this packet will get lost on the way, theek hai, and the sender only resends if the packet is known to have been lost, theek hai. Agar somehow magically if the sender knew, because ye hoga nahi because the packet got lost here on the router, sender ko nahi pata ki packet ke sath kya hashr hua hai, lekin if the packet is only going to retransmit a packet which was lost on the way, theek hai, so then what will happen is ke aapke paas jis rate se ye packets dalega yahan pe, it's going to be a sum of two things. Once again this is going to be asymptotically, it can't go above r by 2 because chahe kuch bhi kare, theek hai, that's the upper bound, r by 2 se zyada nahi ja sakta ye, theek hai, but now when the packet went through it got lost and jo lose hua usne usko retransmit kar diya, theek hai, so the rate at which it is the transport layer is transmitting has two components, ek part uska lambda out sahi receive ho raha hai at the receiver aur dusra part uska jo hai wo because packets have been dropped along the way it has to retransmit them. So as far as lambda n prime is concerned, that when it gets to r by 2, your fraction of packets have been lost and you are retransmitting them, वो फ्रैक्शन आपको लैम्डा आउट में से नहीं मिलेगा, ठीक है? सो लैम्डा आउट इज गोइंग टू बी लेस देन आर बाय टू ओवर हियर. लैम्डा इन प्राइम एट आर बाय टू विल रिजल्ट इन लैम्डा आउट लेस देन आर बाय टू, बिकॉज़ फॉर सम ऑफ दीज पैकेट्स व्हेन यू गॉट हियर दिस क्यू वाज फुल एंड दे हैड टू बी ड्रॉप्ड. बिकॉज दे वर ड्रॉप्ड, they were had to be retransmitted. This is overhead. This is extra work. आपने उन packets को दो दफा भेजा. They are contributing to the input rate over here, but they are not contributing to the output over here because they got lost on the way. So lambda n prime at r by 2 input is not at r by 2, जिस तरह के previous case में था, ठीक है? जब आपके पास loss नहीं है and things are going through perfectly, then lambda n के लिए भी lambda out is r by 2. Here, when you have loss, then at lambda n prime equal to r by 2, lambda out is going to be less than r by 2. Okay? And I can increase my input rate further. Okay? But if I could somehow, if I knew that I'm only going to retransmit these lost packets, and agar wo unki jo hai sort of so asymptotically, this is only going to rise until R by 2. That's the best good put that I can get. And that would be the case where the sender only resends packets which are known to have been lost. Okay? Right, so any question here? Now, realistically, ye jo duplicates hai, ye packets lost bhi ho sakte hain. They could also be dropped at the router. So they're lost because they're dropped at the router because it's full. They could also be, duplicates can also be sent if you prematurely time out and send two copies, both of which are actually delivered over here. Okay? So now you have a further possibility, which is realistic, that na sirf lost packets ke liye aap ye extra packets bhej rahe hain, but because you're timing out too soon, you could also be transmitting packets. Now in that case, what you're going to have then is that because of congestion, okay, you have more work, more retransmissions for a given good put. Okay? So your transmission links are carrying multiple copies of a packet, which decreases the effective good put. Because packets ja rahe hain, two packets bhi receive ho sakte hain at the receiver, and only one of them gets transmitted to the application layer above because it's a duplicate copy. So at the network layer, you've got further congestion taking place and you've got further inefficiencies. Okay? So a realistic scenario is that this doesn't go up all the way to R by 2. It basically tapers off even earlier. Now, if you've got multiple hops, तो फिर एक और scenario भी होता है कि suppose आपके पास दो hops हैं to get from host A to host C. आप इन दो routers के through जा रहे हैं. So think about this: host A is transmitting to host C. This is the red connection over here. It's going through here first router, then it encounters the second router. इसी तरह से उसी time पे एक connection चल रहा है from host B to host D. तो ये जा रहा है थ्रू दिस राउटर ओवर हियर एज वेल एज दिस राउटर ओवर हियर. सो ये जो राउटर ओवर हियर है, इट्स शेयरिंग द रेड एंड ग्रीन लिंक. दिस राउटर ओवर हियर इज शेयरिंग द रेड एंड द ब्लू लिंक, व्हिच इज अ कनेक्शन फ्रॉम होस्ट डी टू होस्ट बी. ठीक है, इसी तरह यू हैव अ पर्पल कनेक्शन ओवर हियर व्हिच इज गोइंग फ्रॉम सी टू ए थ्रू दीज टू राउटर्स. सो फॉर एनी गिवन राउटर, ये जो एक्चुअल पाथ बीइंग फॉलोड है, दैट इज ट्रवर्सिंग मल्टीपल राउटर्स, एंड इट कैन बी दैट पहले राउटर के थ्रू तो पैकेट सही गुजर गया एंड दूसरे राउटर पे जाके कंजेशन आपको मिल गई, तो पैकेट यहां पे ड्रॉप हुआ. ठीक है, सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग नाउ इज दैट इट्स इवन अ वर्स सिचुएशन, बिकॉज यू हैव पैकेट्स विच आर ट्रेवर्सिंग मल्टीपल हॉप्स सक्सेसफुली एंड देन कहीं पे जाके आखिरी हॉप में या बीच में कहीं पे पैकेट गिर गया. सो अगर वो पैकेट गया, इट विल हैव टू बी रिट्रांसमिटेड एंड इट विल हैव टू गो थ्रू ऑल ऑफ दीज हॉप्स. ठीक है. सो दैट मीन्स के जब तक पैकेट सक्सेसफुली नहीं पहुंचा टू द डेस्टिनेशन, जितने भी बीच में इंटरमीडिएट हॉप्स हैं, इट विल हैव टू ट्रेवर्स ऑल ऑफ देम अगेन. ठीक है. सो दैट मीन्स दैट जब कंजेशन होती है एंड यू आर रिट्रांसमिटिंग दोज पैकेट्स अक्रॉस दोज मल्टीपल हॉप्स अगेन, ठीक है, दैट मीन्स मेनी मेनी मोर इनएफिशिएंसीज आर क्रिएटेड. And as a consequence, what happens is that as you increase the rate at which the transport layer is pumping data in, throughput aisa nahi hai ki throughput asymptotically upar hi jaye. Jab ye inefficiencies badhti hain, so then what is happening is a lot of chafing is taking place, jaise aapke paas OS mein hota hai. A lot of work is being done in the network layer, but packets are not being successfully received at the transport layer, which means that aap input rate ko increase kar rahe hain, but the effective output rate, instead of going up asymptotically, is going to start coming down, because jab congestion badhti hai to aap packets will get dropped on any of the intermediate routers and they will have to be retransmitted across those multiple hops, resulting in more efficiencies, further congestion. And what you notice is that आपके पास ट्रैफिक जो है ना वो और मजीद कम होती जाएगी. एंड यू सी दिस ऑल्सो इन लेट्स से ट्रांसपोर्ट नेटवर्क्स. सो गाड़ियां भी अगर एक सर्टन स्पीड के ऊपर विदाउट, जैसे ये व्हेन यू नोटिस दैट विद द सिग्नल फ्री कॉरिडोर्स दैट यू हैव, यू कैन हैव कार्स अराइविंग एट अ सर्टन रेट ऑल गोइंग थ्रू सक्सेसफुली. बट व्हेन यू हैव दीज मल्टीपल लेट्स से traffic signals, ठीक है, in a situation where you've got multiple traffic signals which are akin to routers, जब आप traffic को increase करते हैं beyond a certain limit, the effective throughput is going to go down rather than up beyond a certain limit, ठीक है, especially in the case where you, it's not a correct example because the traffic network is similar to an infinite buffer network, but if packets or cars along the way, if they didn't get to the destination, had to be retransmitted, causing further congestion, then what happens is that as the arrival rate increases, the effective good put is going to go further down. Okay? So when a packet is dropped, any upstream transmission capacity used for that packet is also wasted. Okay? So packet yahan pe drop hua, upstream jo bhi yani उससे पहले ट्रांसमिशन कैपेसिटी जो इस्तेमाल हुई थी वो भी जाया जाएगी, एंड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दैट योर गुड पुट इज गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फॉलिंग डाउन फॉर एनी पैकेट्स दैट आर लॉस्ट अक्रॉस ए मल्टीपल मल्टी हॉप नेटवर्क के अंदर. ओके, राइट. सो देयर मल्टीपल अप्रोचेस टू कंजेशन एंड हाउ टू एलिविएट देम. एक तो ये एंड टू एंड कंजेशन कंट्रोल है, दैट्स द अप्रोच टेकन बाय टीसीपी. Other things that can happen are network assisted congestion control, where somehow the routers tell the end system that congestion is about to take place by setting a single bit or so, and that is how the, rather than waiting for the end system to tell you ki congestion ho rahi hai by sending back a certain window, ya phir ye ki a timeout event takes place and you find out ki congestion hui hai. So that is end-to-end congestion control, like what happens in TCP. Other approaches can be for the intermediate routers to provide feedback to the end systems, telling them that congestion is imminent at the moment and please slow down. Okay. So how does TCP take care of congestion? How does TCP take care of congestion? Well, TCP करता ही है कि the approach that it takes is a very interesting and conservative approach. And what you do is that in the absence of knowledge कि आपके पास network के अंदर कितनी capacity available है, you're going to have a conservative approach, which means that you're going to slowly ramp up or increase the transmission rate. ठीक है, And if congestion takes place, you're going to suddenly reduce the rate at which you are transmitting. And then start slowly probing again, slowly ramping up again. So when congestion takes place, you're going to slow down drastically. And when congestion has not yet taken place, you're going to keep on probing slowly. So you're going to increase the rate at which you're transmitting slowly. Congestion hui ekdam se aap, you'll pull back and you will reduce the rate at which you are transmitting. ठीक है? So ये ऐसे ही है कि आप आहिस्ता-आहिस्ता probe करते जा रहे हैं कि congestion है इतनी. जो ही आपको नजर आता है congestion हुई है, you're going to slow down. फिर आहिस्ता-आहिस्ता चलते जाएंगे जब तक congestion नहीं हुई है, जब तक आपके पास time out नहीं हुआ है, you're going to increase your rate additively. And जो ही congestion hit करते हैं, you're going to at once slow down. And so you will get this sawtooth kind of a behavior. ठीक है जी? Now this is a very interesting example that you have for this. सर्दियों में आप नहाए, ठीक है? What do you do to the tap? ठीक है? You start opening the tap slowly. ठीक है? And जो ही पानी एकदम से ठंडा हो जाता है, you close it. ठीक है? So let's say you're trying to set the temperature. You're going to move the tap very, very slowly until you get to the right temperature. Okay, let's say this is you would like a certain warm temperature, but if it gets too hot, you're going to suddenly close the tap very quickly, maybe to half the value of where this problem occurred, and then slowly start probing again until you get to a comfortable temperature. And as soon as it becomes uncomfortable, you're going to shut the tap down and start probing again. So think of this. You've got multiple users, all using a shared internet. Okay? Each user, kis rate pe transmission kare, it doesn't know. It's going to start at a certain rate and probe. It's going to increase the rate as long as congestion doesn't take place. Congestion kaise pata chalegi? Timeout hoga. आपने पैकेट भेजा, एक वापस नहीं आई आपके पास इन अ रीजनेबल अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम, टाइम आउट होगा. जो ही टाइम आउट हुआ, यू नो कि कंजेशन हो गई. यू आर गोइंग टू स्लो डाउन एंड देन केयरफुली स्टार्ट अगेन बाय प्रोबिंग. ठीक है? द अदर थिंग दैट कैन टेक प्लेस इज दैट यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग डुप्लीकेट एक्स. सो इफ यू गेट डुप्लीकेट एक्स, यू नो दैट योर पैकेट्स आर गोइंग थ्रू सक्सेसफुली, बट सम पैकेट अलोंग द वे, सम सेगमेंट अलोंग द वे इज मिसिंग. That's why आपको duplicate acts मिल रहे हैं. So वो जो missing segment है, उसकी वजह से आपको duplicate acts मिल रहे हैं. So that tells you that congestion has taken place. So two events, either a timeout or receiving three duplicate acts or some number of duplicate acts are going to tell you that congestion has taken place. Okay? So you have a conservative approach where you are going to have an additive increase. And then you're going to, as soon as you get congestion, you're going to cut your congestion window by half and then slowly start probing again. That's the approach that you take. Okay? So notice that TCP uses a pipeline protocol. You have a congestion window, which means that you have a certain credit limit कि इतने पैकेट्स आप भेज सकते हैं. ठीक है? Which are in flight. You can transmit those packets and they can be in flight. Now as soon as you get one ACK back, that slides this window forward. So receiving an ACK successfully tells you that चीजें ठीक जा रही. ठीक है? And it is, think of it like a pacing mechanism, a self-clocking mechanism, that as soon as I receive an ACK back, that gives me confidence, that slides my window one forward and gives me confidence that things are working fine. Jo maine packet ek thoda sa pehle time mein bheja tha, wo successfully pahunch gaya hai aur uski mujhe acknowledgement wapas aa gayi hai. So receiving an ACK back is a very, very good sign and it's telling me that my segment has gone through successfully and I can slide my window forward. Now, एक तरीका ये कि we have a fixed window size, ठीक है? But with a fixed window size, the problem is that suppose I had a large amount of capacity available, ठीक है? With a fixed window size, I will be very inefficient because I could have transmitted at a much higher rate, ठीक है? So somehow I have to dynamically probe for what should be the window size that I can use. So ये जो congestion window है, instead of having a fixed window size, think of this congestion window to be a dynamically changing window now. As I get X back, ठीक है, मैं इस window size को increase करता जाता हूँ. And I start transmitting at a higher rate. Because if I have a larger window size, then I can send more packets without them being acknowledged. More packets can be in flight. Of course, if things go bad, I'll have to retransmit all of them again. But it gives me confidence that if X keeps successfully coming back, I can increase my window size. Now, of course, if you remember, a congestion window aapke paas, jo ki aap ek variable ke taur pe maintain kar rahe hain, and this is dynamically changing based upon the network conditions. How do I estimate network conditions? I estimate network conditions by successfully getting X back without timeouts. I also get an explicit receiver window, which is telling me about flow control. Okay? And the flow control and congestion control window sizes, usme se jo bhi choti hogi, that will be the upper bound at which I can transmit. So notice flow control is also taking place in parallel. The receiver is explicitly telling me kitne mazeed bytes wo le sakta hai. Agar wo thode hai and network congested nahi bhi hai, so I can only transmit at the max of the congestion window and the receive window. Theek hai? So think of this congestion window as a dynamic function, and it is telling me the perceived network congestion, because the bigger it is, the lesser the congestion, the more packets I can transmit. And agar inko transmit karne ke time ke andar mujhe x wapas milna shuru ho jati hai, so effectively the rate at which I'm transmitting is jitne bhi congestion window mein aapke paas bytes hain divided by the round trip transmission time, because that's the time it's going to take for me to get my x back. That is approximately the rate in bytes per second, roughly, in which you are actually transmitting. So the sending rate is roughly the congestion window size divided by your round trip transmission time. Okay. So initially, suppose you start off on the assumption that the initial congestion window size is one maximum segment size, maybe one MSS. One maximum segment size typically would be somewhere about 1500 bytes. So आपको अभी initially कुछ पता नहीं network के बारे में, आपने एक segment भेजी and एक round trip transmission time के बाद आपको उसकी ACK वापस आ गई. So that gives you confidence कि हाँ जी things are going fine. In the next cycle, what you do is you're going to double your congestion window size to 2. And let's say कि आपको दोनों X वापस मिल गए, so now that gives you for more confidence, and you can then transmit 4 segments in the next round trip transmission time, in the next RTT. So this means you're starting slowly, but doubling your congestion window size each time you get those X back, ठीक है? So you're ramping up exponentially fast. It's called a slow start because you're starting slowly, but each time you are ramping up exponentially fast. Now, obviously you can't ramp up exponentially fast forever because you're going to hit congestion very, very quickly. So you have to ramp up fast until a certain threshold size, a threshold number. And that number is another variable called the slow start threshold, SS threshold. So slow start threshold ki koi initial value aapke paas set ho. Suppose initial value of the slow start threshold you've set to 8. So in the first round trip transmission time, theek hai, in the first transmission round aapne ek segment page up. It got through successfully. In the next round, you sent two. They got through successfully. Next round, may you send four. They got through successfully. Next round, may you're going to send in eight. So this is a slow start phase. You're going to keep on doubling the number of segments that you're sending each round until you hit the slow start threshold. This is another variable that aapne apne paas maintain kiya hua hai. On this going to the slow start threshold, aise hi hai jaise aap wo think of the analogy of opening the tap. Initially, you can open the tap pretty fast. You can double the rate at which you're opening it every round. Theek hai? But once you get to a certain level, uske baad you become a bit more careful. And that is where you hit the slow start threshold. Now you start moving it very slowly, which means that you're only increasing it by one per round. So rather than going 1, 2, 4, 8, after hitting the slow start threshold, you're going to increase it by one only per round. So next round mein aap 8 ke baad 9 pe ja rahe hain, phir 10 pe ja rahe hain, phir 11 pe ja rahe hain, aur aista aista ramp karte ja rahe hain. This phase is called the congestion avoidance phase. So you have a very exponentially rising slow start phase. We call it slow start because aap shuru 1 se kar rahe. So it's a slow start phase because you're starting 1, but you're rising exponentially until you hit a slow start threshold. This is another variable jo aapne apne paas maintain kiya ho. Theek hai? Then you start rising linearly. Theek hai? It's an additive increase, but it's only 1 per transmission round until you hit congestion. Now, when you hit congestion, that is where a timeout takes place or you get 3 duplicate acts. So, jo hi congestion aap hit karte hain, to aap kya karte hain ki ek to jo slow start threshold ka variable aapne rakha hua hai separate, uski value ko half kar dete hain. So, suppose you hit congestion at a place which was 12. So, congestion window 12 thi in terms of segment sizes, maximum segment sizes when you hit congestion. So now the slow start threshold is going to be set to 6. And you're going to go all the way from 12 to 1 again, rise up exponentially until the slow start threshold. So you're going to go 1, 2, 4. And 4 ke baad aap 8 pe ja sakte hain, but you're not going to exceed the slow start threshold. So you're going to go up to 6. And then 6 ke baad you're going to rise again slowly, linearly. Take it. So you have two phases. You're basically probing in all of these phases. Probing aap jaldi se karte hain until you hit a threshold. Uske baad you probe very slowly by only increasing the number of the congestion window size by 1 every transmission round. Take it. And lekin whenever you hit congestion, you're going to go all the way down to 1 again. That was the previous implementation, jo ki TCP, ke shuru ki implementations, Tahoe ke naam se hai, which are lakes in sort of California. Uske baad, the next implementation that came through found out ki achi, or suggested that, well, rather than going all the way down to 1, agar timeout ho raha hai, phir to 1 pe jaye. लेकिन अगर लेट्स से टाइम आउट नहीं हो रहा और आपको आपके पास डुप्लीकेट एक्स आ रहे हैं, उसका मतलब है कि एक सेगमेंट जो है ना वो घूम रही है बीच में, लेकिन बाकी चूंकि एक्स आपके पास आ रहे हैं और डुप्लीकेट एक्स आ रहे हैं, यू नो दैट नेटवर्क इज नॉट दैट मच कंजेस्टेड. ठीक है, अ पैकेट गॉट लॉस्ट ऑन द वे समहाउ, बट यू स्टिल गेटिंग डुप्लीकेट एक्स बैक, व्हिच इज गिविंग यू कॉन्फिडेंस दैट द नेटवर्क इज वर्किंग. सो रादर देन गोइंग ऑल द वे डाउन टू 1, यू बेसिकली स्टार्ट एट योर slow start threshold when you get 3 duplicate acts. So on receiving 2 duplicate acts, instead of going back to 1, in TCP Tahoe you go back to 1. Whether it's a timeout or you get 3 duplicate back acts, you go back to 1. TCP Reno, which is a newer version, usme ye hai ki you're going, if you get a timeout, you go back to 1. If you get 3 duplicate acts, you only go to half the value of your slow start threshold and start probing from here. ठीक है, until आपके पास वो act वापस आ जाती है, उसके बाद आप इसको deflate करते हैं and you continue from there. We'll get to the details of that. So these are two commonly used or क्या कहते हैं टीसीपी के फ्लेवर्स हैं टाहो एंड रीनो. इसके अलावा और देर आर सॉर्ट ऑफ टेन्स ऑफ डिफरेंट न्यूअर एल्गोरिथम्स विच हैव बीन सजेस्टेड एंड उनकी परफॉर्मेंस और इम्प्लीमेंटेशंस के ऊपर बहुत सारे रिसर्च पेपर्स हैं विच आर ऑफ ग्रेट इंटरेस्ट टू पीपल वर्किंग इन दिस एरिया. सो इन समरी यू गॉट लॉस इंडिकेटेड बाय अ टाइम आउट. जब लॉस होता है विद द टाइम आउट यू सेट द कंजेशन विंडो टू वन and then grow exponentially, which is called the slow start phase, which is a slightly misnomer because you're rising exponentially, but because you're starting from one, it's a slow start phase, until you hit a threshold, which is called the slow start threshold, the SS threshold. Uske baad you start increasing linearly. If the loss is indicated by the receiving through duplicate acts, then Reno ke case mein, what you do is that because the duplicate acts are indicating that the network is capable of delivering some segments, you simply start from the, you cut down your congestion window to half and grow linearly. Taho mein, dono cases mein, timeout ho, ya teen duplicate acts hai, you're always going to start with a congestion window size of one and then grow exponentially. You will set the new value of the slow start threshold to half of where the problem occurred. So slow start threshold को आप half the value of जहाँ problem हुई है उस value पे आप set कर देते हैं, ठीक है जी? So any questions here जी? Taho, Reno and this behavior of when congestion takes place इसके बारे में.
ठीक है. Assalam alaikum sir.
जी.
Sir congestion control में जो congestion window है हमारी sir वो zero हो सकती है अगर हमारे पास कोई है कि नहीं आ रही तो.
नहीं one से start है.
Minimum one होगी.
देखिए ये स्लो स्टार्ट है इसका फाइनाइट स्टेट मशीन देखें. कंजेशन विंडो आपने स्टार्ट की वन मैक्सिमम सेगमेंट साइज से, तो अगर आप 22 में काम कर रहे हैं तो वन मैक्सिमम सेगमेंट साइज इज गोइंग टू बी 1460 बाइट्स और 1500 बाइट्स आप समझ लें. और आपने स्लो स्टार्ट थ्रेशोल्ड की कोई इनिशियल वैल्यू रख दी, बस 64 किलोबाइट्स आपने रख दी, ठीक है? सो ये तो इन दो वेरिएबल्स, एक कंजेशन विंडो है और एक थ्रेशोल्ड है, ये दो वेरिएबल्स आपको इनिशियली सेट करने हैं स्टार्ट करने के टाइम पे, ठीक है? Similarly, you need to keep track of कितने duplicate acts आपको मिले हैं. Initially, वो आपने count zero कर दिया, ठीक है? अगर time out होता है, आपने congestion window को one कर देना है, duplicate acts count को भी zero कर देना है, and slow start threshold को half the value of the congestion window size. जहाँ भी congestion हुई है, उस वक्त जो भी congestion window का size था, उसकी आधी value के ऊपर threshold को set करना है. ठीक है, ये नोटिस करें ये दो अलग चीजें हैं. ये जो ब्लू में दिखा रहे हैं ये इन एनी गिवन राउंड कंजेशन विंडो का साइज आप दिखा रहे हैं. कंजेशन विंडो इन सेगमेंट्स, दिस इज द ब्लू वैल्यू दैट यू आर शोइंग. द कंजेशन विंडो साइज इज डायनामिकली बीइंग एडजस्टेड अकॉर्डिंग टू द नेटवर्क कंडीशंस. थ्रेशोल्ड के साइज को आप फिक्स रख रहे हैं और थ्रेशोल्ड एक सिंपली एक वेरिएबल है जो आपको ये बताता है कि उस जब विंडो साइज उससे नीचे हो तो आप एक्सपोनेंशियली राइज करें, विंडो साइज उससे बड़ी हो तो आप लीनियरली राइज करें. थ्रेशोल्ड रखने का फायदा सिर्फ ये है कि आपको ये बता रहा है कि आप कहां तक जल्दी जल्दी राइज कर सकते हैं और किस वैल्यू के बाद आपको केयरफुली राइज करना है, ठीक है? सो इनिशियली आपने थ्रेशोल्ड साइज को कुछ वैल्यू रखी, मसलन 8 रखी आपने, विंडो साइज 1 रखा, तो देन यू कैन गो 1, 2, 4, 8. तो हर राउंड में आपने डबल करते गए कंजेशन विंडो को. When the congestion window hits the slow start threshold value, उसके बाद हर round पे आपने एक से increase करते गए congestion window को. यहीं पे जाके congestion हुई. Congestion कैसे हुई? या तो आपके पास timer timeout कर गया, या आपके पास तीन duplicate acts आ गए. अगर timer timeout कर गया, तो आपने क्या करना है? Threshold को जिस value पे timeout हुआ है, value क्या थी? 12. Congestion window की value 12 थी जब timeout हुआ. तो आपने थ्रेशोल्ड की नई वैल्यू को 12/2 6 पे सेट कर दिया, ठीक है? थ्रेशोल्ड को 6 पे सेट किया लेकिन विंडो को 1 पे ही सेट किया. अब विंडो 1 से लेके 6 तक एक्सपोनेंशियली राइज कर सकती है, उसके बाद लीनियरली राइज करेगी. तो टाहो में 1, 2, 4 के बाद आपने 8 पे जाना था लेकिन 8 पे आप थ्रेशोल्ड हिट कर जाएंगे, देयरफॉर आप 8 पे नहीं जाएंगे, 4 के बाद 6 पे जाएंगे और 6 के बाद फिर लीनियरली राइज करेंगे टू 7, 8, 9, थ्रेशोल्ड यहीं पे रहेगा। अब सपोज 9 पे आपको कंजेशन मिल गई दोबारा से, अब आपने स्लो स्टार्ट थ्रेशोल्ड को इसके हाफ वैल्यू रखना है एंड दोबारा से 1 से स्टार्ट करके ऊपर जाना है। अगर डुप्लीकेट एक्स मिल रहे हैं तो टाहो में वही काम करना है जो कि टाइम आउट पे करना है, लेकिन रीनो में इट्स अ न्यूअर प्रोटोकॉल एंड डुप्लीकेट एक्स सजेस्ट कि कंजेशन इतनी सिवियर नहीं है कि आप टाइम आउट कर रहे हैं, एक्स आपको मिल रहे हैं, तो 3 डुप्लीकेट एक्स मिलने पे आप क्या करेंगे कि विंडो आपकी पहले 12 थी, आपने विंडो को हाफ से आगे लेके जाना है और लीनियरली दोबारा से राइज करना है। ठीक है, If you read papers, you will find कि वो actually करते हैं कि जो half value है, ठीक है, congestion window divide by 2, उसमें वो जो 3 duplicate tax मिले उसका भी plus 3 करके, अब बजाय 6 से start करने से, if you see the book, they start from 9 and that's what you do in papers as well. तो congestion window को आप जहाँ पे मसला हुआ था 3 duplicate tax मिले थे, divide that by 2, add 3 and start your congestion window from there. So start threshold आपने नीचे रखा हुआ है एंड यू ही आप एक मिलती है, यू डिफ्लेट योर कंजेशन विंडो अगेन एंड कंटिन्यू। ठीक है जी, सो स्लो स्टार्ट्स फेज कंटिन्यूज अंटिल यू गेट टू योर स्लो स्टार्ट थ्रेशोल्ड, अबव योर स्लो स्टार्ट थ्रेशोल्ड देन यूर इन द कंजेशन अवॉइडेंस फेज एंड ऑन रिसीविंग ईच एक यूर ओनली राइजिंग लीनियरली। ठीक है, डुप्लीकेट एक्स आपको 3 मिल जाए तो यू डू अ फास्ट रिकवरी विच मीन्स दैट आप उसको टाइम आउट से पहले उस पैकेट को दोबारा भेज देते हैं एंड अगर इस फास्ट रिकवरी फेज के बावजूद आप टाइम आउट कर जाते हैं या 3 डुप्लीकेट एक्स मजीद आपको मिल जाते हैं, यू गोइंग टू गो बैक टू स्लो स्टार्ट। ठीक है, सो टेक अ लुक एट दीज फाइनाइट स्टेट मशीन्स एंड इंशाल्लाह वी हैव one more maybe a few more minutes on this throughput discussion, but that will sort of round off the discussion on the TCP chapter. Right, so any questions?
Sir, slow start threshold sir hum increase kaise karte hain sir, to abhi to hum decrease kar rahe hain na retransmitter timeout ke case mein, to increase kis criteria pe hoga? Ye
slow start threshold increase tabhi hoga, let's say pehle 8 pe tha, theek hai, start threshold, अब आपने 8 के बाद लीनियरली राइज करना है एंड लेट्स से आप राइज करते हैं और आप राइज करते हैं ऑल द वे अप टू 30। ठीक है, 30 पे जाके आपको टाइम आउट हुआ। ठीक है, तो अब जब आप दोबारा से स्टार्ट करेंगे तो आप 1 पे ही स्टार्ट करेंगे तो यानी कंजेशन विंडो को, लेकिन थ्रेशोल्ड की वैल्यू को, चूंकि मसला 30 पे आया था, तो आप थ्रेशोल्ड की वैल्यू को 8 से 15 पे ले जाएंगे। So now you can very easily ramp from 1, 2, 4, 8 and 15 तक आप 4 steps के अंदर जल्दी से ramp up कर जाएंगे। ठीक है, तो जहां मसला आता है उस value of congestion window को आप divide by 2 करके अपना नया threshold value set कर लेते हैं। तो अगर मसला नहीं आ रहा है, you're ramping up and network ठीक चल रहा है, you're going to a congestion window size of 30, 40, 50, वहां मसला आता है, you can straight away set your new threshold to half that value, जो के उससे threshold value increase होते जाए। Okay? Any further questions? जी, yes, we're out of time. Thank you, जी, thank you. Okay, so that's it. Inshallah. See you inshallah on Friday morning. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.